Hello everyone, my name is David Garcia. Welcome to our space, Simulaciones Finitas. Today we have this publication where they tackle the problem of seismic analysis for open top storage tanks. This work was done by Professor Azzuni and his knowledgeable teamwork at Purdue University. So let's get started. This publication considers the rigid wall criteria to define the seismic interaction, which means, in other words, they define a pressure wall profile in order to see the global stresses and strains on the storage tanks, for example, like this one. This problem is solved considering two load steps. The first one includes the hydrostatic pressure, where we can see a uniform load, and the self-weight load. Then comes the hydrodynamic load, where we can see the general distortion of the shell, like the elephant's foot buckling here. And also, we can see the bottom uplift at the opposite side. That is taken into account, we defined previously the elastic support condition for the bottom. In this paper, they consider both fixed support and flexible foundation, right? This problem was solved based on Jacobson-Belitsov's expression for pressure wall. However, there are several ways to address this phenomenon. For example, explicit dynamics or coupling physics as well. The explicit dynamics implies we are considering the fluid in the simulation and we are checking the bottom in order to see how the model behaves. One example of this kind of behavior, we have it here at the screen, where the darker blue particles represent the water and this metal container suffers general distortion because it is impacted against a rigid wall. Another example for seismic load, we have it here with one acceleration response spectrum. This is a typical diagram from seismic codes. And here we have one equipment with equivalent stresses from its operating condition, where the equivalent stress ranges from 10,000 psi to 30,000 psi. But moreover, we have stresses from one acceleration response spectrum, which adds around 2000 psi to the equipment, especially at the support, okay? So that's another example of how we can address these kind of problems, and I hope you like it and stay to the very end. Thank you. To continue with the seismic problem, there are three aspects I want to talk about here. The first one is related to the geometry, where three types of tanks were drawn. One slender tank, like this one, where we can see its buckling region. Another one is this chart and white tank, where its failure mode is different to the previous one. And finally, this tank, where its diameter and height are equal. Considering the supports, there are two types, one fixed at the base and one elastic support which work as a spring. Here we can see the supports. Here we have our fixed support and here we have our elastic support with a fixed support at the center to ease convergence. We have already talked about the load, where we consider the hydrostatic load, self-weight load, and here we can display those settings. Here's the gravity. Nonetheless, for the hydrodynamic load, we shall consider two behaviors. The first one is named impulsive load, whose magnitude is higher at the base. And decreases till the top, as you can see here in the graph. And secondly, a convected load, which is stronger at the top of the shell because of the sloshing phenomenon. Both loads are applied to the bottom in a quasi-static analysis. From a general perspective, the impulsive load is higher for slender tanks, but convective is higher for short and wide storage tanks. We can see that easily when we compare the applied pressure on the shell. For example, for this short and wide tank, we have a pressure around 1.5 psi, which is lesser than the slender tank, whose pressure is around 5.5 psi. So that makes a big difference. Here at the bottom, you can see the pressure load, as I told you. And with this, now we can continue with the results of this simulation. Now we will see the results of our simulation and we will compare them to the ones on the publication. What you see at the screen belongs to tank number 2. And here we can see the hoop stress, which behaves similarly to the stress on the paper, considering the numeric values and how it is distributed. The longitudinal stress works fine as well. If we consider this sum, for example, and the range of values where they are similar one another. We can also say that for this region at the left here, the graph that we see at your left, it's a different way to show that 100% of the load was applied to the model because of this one on the axis. And this value at the x-axis, it's another way to show the increase of radial growth because of hydrostatic and hydrodynamic loads. Then we can conclude that the simulation for tank number 2 are properly addressed, and its failure mode and the distributed stresses are acceptable. Let's see now the slender tank, where it has a bulking problem. One way to confirm this is with the proportional load factor, where it does not reach 100%. There is no 1 in the y-axis, as in the previous model. This is a typical behavior for bulking problems, and that happens because of the axial force on the tank exceeds the buckling strength of the tank and it fails. This is the longitudinal stress, which behaves similarly to publication. However, at the left there is a difference, and this is mainly because we obtained the result from a polar coordinate system. But if we move to the default solution for membrane stress from ANSYS, we see that those results behave more similar. From this, we can say that the failure mode is coherent compared to the publication, right? Now, I want to show you the last tank, whose aspect ratio is the smallest. Here, we didn't consider the wind girdle at the top of the shell, which makes the storage tank more prone to failure because of lack of stability at the top, less stiffened. And we can see that here in these results of a fixed base tank, where at the top, we have around 1 inch of deformation, 1.5 in its maximum value near the bottom. Here is the fixed support. But for the elastic support, we see how the deformation at the top increases. And here we are not capable to achieve convergence. So that's the review of the results. And what is left is our section thinking out of the box. I want to show you this little experiment where we parameterize the aspect ratio and thicknesses of a tank in order to have a different geometry with different stresses values, having at the end a surface response for bending and membrane stresses. This is possible because of the design of experiment and all its capabilities in response surface interface. May it be defined as a chart for acceptable criteria? Let's hope we can publish a serious work after refining all of this. Thank you very much for staying on until the end. Thank you to Professor Azzuni for his opinion. We would appreciate your comments below and feedbacks. Thank you and goodbye.